I already have a glitter speck on my forehead, how? Well, hello my lovely nestlings and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 45. I want to say 44, but I'm not. I'm 45 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today I'm getting ready and I'm playing with new stuff. Yeah, what I also got today, or no, a few days ago, is the Norns collection from Odin's Eye. I have the big palette, as you saw. I have the three mini palettes. I have one highlighter and I have two scarves. I was debating on the palette that I wanted to use, but I think I'm going to go for the big palette, because fun fact is that Oort, the small one, this one, is the one that I was most excited about, because I love the whole mythology behind it, but the oldest sister, Oort, is one that I feel the most connection with. I also love the color story, but I kind of want to do this one first off camera. I don't know. It feels more personal that way. So, I'm going to play with the big Norns palette today, and I actually have kind of a look in mind. I don't know if I will hold on to that though, but I kind of wanted to do teal today. So here is the color story of the big palette. You all have seen it. I'm not going to do a separate review on the entire collection, because everyone and their mother have already reviewed this. I also bought the collection purely for me, not specifically to make videos on. If you guys really want me to use the entire collection, let me know down below. But I actually think I will just play with them and maybe film it for Instagram, you know, instead of making separate video. You will see it popping up here and there though. But yeah, that's what my plan was. And what else did I get? I got Fenty foundation and the concealer. I have the Pro Filter foundation in the shade 145, which is light olive, I believe. And when you look at it like this, especially with the frosted glass, you're like, ooh, it's very green and very light. But when it is a little bit darker when you use it. I also got the concealer because I thought it, I don't know, it would be handy maybe. So there is a pretty big color difference between the two. But yeah, so I want to use those today. What do I want to start with? I don't know. I kind of wanted to focus maybe a little bit more on the face today instead of the eyes, because I want basically the eyes to be pretty simple. So I thought let's kind of get ready. First impression face stuff. That was what I want to focus on today. So I think I'm going... I don't have a primer on, because I actually want to see what the foundation does on its own. I am, however, going to color correct a tiny bit underneath my eye. Just a little. To help combat a little bit of the darker circles. I already have a glitter speck on my forehead. How? So yeah, I used the Revolution, what is it, Conceal and Define in Peach. It's just a tiny amount that I need, so it's not very drying for my face, which is good. Shall we start with face? Or shall we start with eyes? I kind of want to start with the face, because I'm excited about it. What can I say? So yeah, the Fenty Pro Filter Foundation, Shake Well. So let's do that. And I ordered this from Sephora, and if I order from Sephora, I have to order from Sephora France. Gotta love Google Translate, because my French is not good at all. I used to be very good in French, but it has been a while. But this foundation, and or at least this shade, was what was it? 30% off, I believe. So I was like, yeah, this is my chance to order this foundation right now. So yeah, let's pump a little bit on the... I don't know how full coverage it is though, so we will start with one pump. So here I have the shade, which is, when you look at it right now, it's still pretty green, but it should be okay, I think. So let's just bounce it on the face and see how it is. Not gonna lie, it's pretty olive, and I kind of got scared when I put it on, but it looks to match my neck very nicely. Or am I very much mistaken? I don't think so. Did I change? Oh yeah, I also changed the camera settings a tiny bit. So I hope that they are good. Okay, so basically that was one pump that I used. It feels... I remember when I reviewed the NARS foundation, that I was before I went cruelty free, the pump system on that one was also smaller pumps, and it's also with this one it almost feels like half a pump as well, same as with the NARS. So I'm actually doing another pump. Let's also bring it up a little bit. On my forehead I usually don't need much, because my forehead is a pretty even color scheme. I do want my brow bone. And usually the most redness I have is on my cheeks. And I have hyperpigmentation there as well. But I also have rosacea. So, wow. I don't know how it translates on camera, but when I look in the mirror, it seems to be a very, very nice match for me. Which is very, very good. Now, it is a matte finish. Oh, wow. It has already set as well. Wow, I did not... Is it splotchy? It's not. Can I build it up? I want to know if I can build it up. So I have a tiny bit more, and it has already set. Wow. But it doesn't feel dry, so let's see if I can build it up. What happens then? Just on the cheeks. I want to know if it is split. Sometimes foundations basically lift off if you want to build on them. Doesn't seem to be the case here though. And I can see by my tattoo here that I don't, at least not here on the side, I don't have a lot of coverage. But I have coverage. Wow. I actually think I'm going to really like this foundation, which is a bummer, because that means that I need darker shades for in the summer, you know? Wow. Okay, now my skin type is... you know, I feel it's pretty normal, not gonna lie. It is not overly dry, it is not oily, it can get a little bit dehydrated, and in winter I am more dry, but that's also because I, a lot of the time, fail to drink enough. So... yeah, there is that. But wow. So I don't have a very overly dry face, I feel at least. Wow, and the nice thing is it does not feel like I need to set it either. Wow. Okay. Nabla stuff, because I need plump lips. Yes. The concealer, let's shake that one as well. Now I also got the Revolution, what is it, Conceal and Define, but the Infinite, because these are, I think, different than the normal Conceal and Define. I also got the shade 5.7, which is light olive, because I wanted to try that one too. That is it. But let's see how this one is. Oh, it's almost, wow, it's almost looking neon, just a tiny bit. I actually like to apply my concealer with my fingers, which is sometimes challenging if you have longer nails, but still. And I also color corrected, you remember? So, yeah, that's that. Okay, little goes a long way, let's grab the sponge. It is a pretty, I don't know, a brightening concealer almost. It's also pretty pale, which I'm not really used to. I'm grabbing a little bit of foundation, what I have left, and I'm tapping it over. Because I'm not used to a very, very bright under eye. And this was also shade 145, right? Yeah, 145. So let's kind of see if I can dot there and dot there just a little to I don't know, let's be fancy. I actually think this is a pretty full coverage concealer, but I'm not sure. I do know that this isn't one that I can use in summer. Unless I use it underneath the foundation. So I'm basically going to hopefully correct a little bit of the bag area that I have. That's what you get when you don't drink enough, or at least that's what it is for me. You know, and not gonna lie, I'm going to put a little bit of foundation over because it is just too light for my liking. That's okay though, because now I know that I can use this to brighten up underneath stuff as well. Okay, so here's the foundation on. It feels set, and it is so weird to feel the foundation setting. Usually when I feel a foundation setting, it itches, and it doesn't. I say while I'm scratching my thing. But yeah. Let's see if I can kind of darken it up a bit. Ah, here. So this is how the foundation is looking. You know what it reminded me of? Back in the day when I could still rock the Superstay from Maybelline. If I use that one now, it's way, way, way too drying for me. And it emphasizes everything. And I don't feel like this is a very, very matte finish. It is just a finish. Okay. Let's zoom back. Oh no, that's the wrong sign. I think this was the setting that I used, right? Or did I use this one? I don't remember. Yeah, I don't feel like I need to set it. I don't feel like it emphasizes my pores very, very much or my lines. It seems to flex very well with my face. And now that it is kind of warming up to my face, it feels very nice. Not gonna lie. Okay, I want my brows. Let's do them first. So I can feel a little bit more human. Apparently, we are in werewolf mode today. Maybe because werewolf is also kind of Norse mythology. You know, actually, werewolf means wolfman. Because were means man and wolf is wolf, but that's okay. And just a tidbit here and there. I also have these two from Makeup Revolution. So the shade C112 and 115, which are both on the olive spectrum. Okay. Can I do something with this? I think I could use this one as a bronzer. And this one, I don't know. Or is this the cool one and that's the warm? You know, I never know. This one is also almost more red, and it apparently oxidizes quite a bit. Will that work as a contour? Probably not, but I'm going to try it anyway. Because I want to. Leave me alone. So let's get a brush. Yes, I know that you. I'm actually going to grab some from my hand. Let's see. Yeah, that's not it, but that's okay. And I can see that it is not the correct shade, but yeah, what can you do? The Fenty stick that I had is way worse, so. Yeah, oh, it oxidizes a lot, actually. I do think I can use this as a bronzer though. Or shall I use the other shade as a bronzer? This one. I'm blending them out on my hand. I almost want to use this one, the more redder one, as a bronzer and this one as a contour. But yeah. I don't know. So I have the lighter one now, but it's very almost yellow on my head, which is probably my, I don't know, better summer shade, you know. I'm very much overthinking this again, as per usual. And I could obviously just use the shade that I'm using now, the lighter one, to sculpt with as well a little, to just give a little bit of definition. To the face instead of Truly, because now that I'm blending it out, it kind of seems to move with my skin better. Or at least that's what it looks like when I look in the mirror. I don't know how it looks on camera or how it looks outside. But I think I will like the shade 11.5 more as a bronzer. Is it this shade? Yeah. So I'm just putting some on the back of my hand. And then with the butt of the sponge, let's kind of put it over a bit. How's that? I don't know. Yeah, I actually think that that C.2 is, I don't know, it makes me almost overly green. And this one, the 11.5, I think it's actually pretty as a bronzer as well. So I'm going to put that one to the side and I'm going to try this one. And I also have something from Juvia's Place, which is maybe even a better color yet. Let's use this one for contour. Why? Because I can. That's the only reason. I think it's too warm almost. But maybe that's just me. Maybe I just need to, I don't know. Maybe I just shouldn't stop worrying. Maybe I should just stop worrying about it a little bit and just go with the flow. Something like that. I don't know, people. What kind of blush do I want? Let me see. I do not really have a new blush.
This one too much, I think so. Yeah, let me put that one in the basket as well.
Let me grab Tiger Lily. So I have here MUA Tiger Lily on the back of the hand. Let me whack on my blush and my freckles. Okay, I've also added a little bit of ColourPop's Wisp on the face. And yeah, blush I mentioned, right? Tiger Lily from MUA, Lottie London Freckle Pen, and that is it. I don't feel like I need to set my face, so I'm not going to set my face. I could, if I wanted to, at the ending, if I'm like, it's maybe a little bit, I don't know, too matte or whatever, I could always add something, but now that it has been on for a little longer, it is basically settling, and I won't say it's becoming oily. It's not. It's, I don't know, it's just feeling like my skin. That's how it feels. Okay, I also primed my eyes with a Natasha Denona eye base. Let me grab some brushes and the palette, because it is time for eyes. So yeah, here is the palette that I'm going to use today, which is very, very pretty. And I want, I already said that, right? I want teal. I want to do a teal look with this one. So that's what I'm going to do. So I don't want, I don't think it's going to be complicated. It's probably going to be a one crease look. Maybe I will use the shade Dazed first. Let me do that, because that looks like a little bit more of a greener, I don't know. Maybe I can use that to kind of, let's start with the shade Dazed, which is that, I don't know what kind of color. Just to have a tiny bit of set base to blend that teal shadow on. I do see the concealer creasing underneath my eye a bit though. And because it has already set, I cannot really tap it out. So I need to do that a little bit differently next time. But what I can do is just put some eyeshadow on top. And then basically blend it out a bit. Oh yeah. The shade Outsider, which is the teal. Let's go there. I'm just going to look down. I'm just going to tap it on. I need to kind of be careful a little bit because I haven't set my face. So everything that falls down will probably stick. Going to go back to that shade Days, the first shade that I used, that grayer shade, just to help blend the edge a little. And just to make sure that it isn't, I don't know, patchy, harsh line, whatever. You know, the gist of this collection is, at least for me, if you want it, get it. If you don't want it, then don't get it. Yeah, that sounds maybe a little bit simple, but I wasn't planning on doing a review on this collection because for me, the reason that I bought it is just because I love the brand and this theme is just so me. It's pretty blue, isn't it? Which is okay. But we will deepen it up. A little. I'm taking tiny amount for here in the corner, but I don't want it too low. I'm still in the same shade, which is the shade Outsider. I just switched brushes and I'm going to build it up. Yeah, I can build it up all I want, but it's going to remain blue. I'm going to go to the shade Colorful Black, which is actually a satin. Or at least that's what it looked like. I want a little bit more depth in the crease and in the outer corner. Tiny bit of that same shade, the black, in the outer corner here. On the lower lash line. Pencil. That was what I was thinking. I'm going to grab my dark teal pencil from Kiko. Okay, then that brush. I'm just going to smudge a little bit of that pencil that I put there. I'm going to smudge it. Yes, we have a very heavy teal bottom today. Okay, I think it's shimmer time. Let's get the glitter primer. It's not that I think that the shimmer's needed. It's just that I kind of hope to kind of not have as much fallout if I use a glitter primer. That's what I want today. So let's just put it on the eye. I don't have to be very precise though. And then I'm going to go in the shade Hallucination. Oh, that's very pretty. Very pretty, very chunky too. And glittery, so I can kind of see the glittery bits falling on my face a bit, but I'm glad that I have glitter primer on my brush because it sticks a little bit better to the brush. Oh, it's very nice and shiny when you go over it with your finger, so I'm just going to do that. Not really my favorite, but I just noticed that the brush is just not picking up what I wanted to pick up. I'm going to go back to the teal shade called Outsider, the matte. I feel very much like a sparkling sea, a sparkling mermaid right now. I very, very much love this shimmer. Yes. inner corner. I'm going to go to the shade Optimism. I don't know how I got all the glittery bits on the side of my nose, but I have all the glittery bits on the side of my nose. Let's spray the shade a bit. These are very unusual shimmers. Because they are almost glittery when you look at them. But when you feel them, they're very... almost oily. It's a very... I don't know. Oh, yes, that is what you have. Damn it, how am I going to get rid of that? I'm not, I think. I don't really know how my under eyes are looking right now, but I put a little bit of foundation underneath. I do feel, though, that it oxidizes, which isn't a bad thing. But that is what it feels like. That when I just put it on, it's very... Yeah, it feels like it's oxidizing. But that is okay. Do need a little bit of my freckles back then. Oh yeah, I also have the highlighter. I forgot the highlighter. I forgot that I also have the highlighter in Web of Fate, right? Web of Destiny, almost. It's almost the same. Which looks like this. Which should be a very, very pinkish one. But let's try it. I have glittery bits on my face. I do, but that's probably because I went swirling with my brush, but not a lot, because I don't really want to F up the embossing. What's this? What are you? I don't know, a thingy. Okay, I'm going to finish off the face, and then I will be back and show you the completed look. Everything is on, here is the final look. As you see, I kind of spruced up the whole ensemble a little bit. Let's start with the falsies. They are from AOA Studio in the style Jean, which are... Yeah, basically your true 3D foaming falsies. And I thought that they would give a little bit of drama, but still keep it a little bit open and light and airy, like the weather or something. Lippy is from Juvia's Place. Where did I put it? I think it was the shade Muted. Let's see. Was it the shade Muted? I think so. I already put it back. Yeah, no, well, it's actually the shade Toffee, but that's okay. So, the shade Toffee. Yes. Falsies I already mentioned. Yeah, I added a different nose piercing and some fancy-ass earring pluck thingamajingies. So yeah, let's kind of go over everything, or at least the foundation. Because you know what, the eyeshadow collection, I'm not going to review it. I already decided I'm not going to review it. I do have blue glittery bits on my face though, not gonna lie. But I don't mind, because it's so very, very nice and sparkly. Let's go to the foundation though, because... I want to play with this one a little bit more. Why do I say that? Because I see that in some places it is... I don't want to say it is breaking up, because it's not. It's just that I am used to foundations that stay tacky for longer, that I can basically work with a little bit longer than this one. Because this one dries down pretty quickly, actually. Which isn't a bad thing, it's just I want to play with it a little bit more. Maybe I will do a foundation review on it as well. I think I will. Just because I do really want to test it out. First impression though is I really do like it. It is a little bit unusual for me to have a foundation that dries down so completely. So I do want to try it with different primers as well. I do feel... like it looks a little bit dry underneath my eyes. But yeah, I kind of did stuff under there. So that's not really weird. I don't know if I like the concealer as much. But I want to keep on trying with that one as well. So far, the first impression on the foundation is that I like it. However, if you have very dry skin, unless you prep your skin correctly with your skincare and put a hydrating primer underneath, I think this will be too drying for you. Just based on how it is on my skin without a primer. Yeah, that's it. Without a primer. And I haven't had that much to drink today either. So I can kind of feel that my face is getting a little bit dehydrated. Which is my own fault. But yeah, so if you have very dry skin, I don't think you will like the foundation. But that's just based on my first impression. And I do want to play with it more. What I did do though, is I added a little bit of buffing powder on top. This is the Waterflower Magic Perfecting Powder from Kiko Milano. Which is a very, very tiny sheen. And when I actually used this to set underneath my eyes, and I did not really feel that I needed to set underneath my eyes. But when I did, it made it look better. Which is kind of weird, because usually if you add powder, it makes it look more powdery. But it didn't. So I very lightly powdered it, and then I basically went buffed over my face. And it looks even better now. I don't feel like it is really settling into lines either. Maybe here a tiny bit, there, that part. But yeah, that's also a part that's very movable, so that's not really weird. But yeah, again, I do want to keep on trying this. But yeah, I will keep on using it, and I will give you my final answer either in a separate video. If you really want me to do a separate video on this, let me know down below. Or I'm just going to mention it at the end of, well, basically when my February review will go online, which is at the end of March, beginning of April, when that will go online. So yeah, let me know if you have any of the stuff. And that is it, I think. Oh yeah, the foundation, the concealer stuff from Revolution, right? I think that the shade that I used now, which was 11.5, which is a little bit more of the redder one. I don't know if it's necessarily cooler. I feel it's warmer because it's more red, but maybe I'm mistaken. I don't know. But it is 11.5. I like that as a bronzer. Not necessarily as a contour shade. And I can use the other one, which is 11.2 as bronzer as well. But I feel like it is too yellow. Almost. But maybe that is me. Maybe I can. Maybe I need to try this one a little bit more as a contour shade then. To give a subtle difference in my face. I don't know. Maybe it's just the wrong shade altogether. But that's okay. I do want to get a good contour shade though. But I will keep on looking for that. Yes, this was it for today's video. Let me know down below if you have any of the things. Didn't I already mention that? I did, didn't I? I'm just going to go to the site to give a special thank you to my members that you will see scrolling on the screen right now. If you want to become a member, there is a link to join in the description box, and there's also a link to the merch, Teespring merch store shop thingamajingy, where you can find lots of fun goodies, or at least I think they are fun. Yes. That's it for today. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. I think mine does very well today. And I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye guys.